Peygamber, no doubt he used to mean like qualified Amir al-Mu'mineen, but now it means the ulama, no doubt, because they are the, you know, authority. You can see, قُرَا سَيَا إِلَذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ قَالَ اللَّهُ أَطِيعُوا بِهِ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ أُوبِي مَسَنْجَرَ But when only the Amr comes, they know أَطِيعُوا, it's basically part of the same thing. So it is very clear, obedience of ulama is not independent. It is basically part of the obedience of Allah and Messenger. Okay? If ulama are experts, they explain to you what Allah and His Messenger say. But if ulama have problem, then Quran says the same words, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ But if you have a dispute, ulama dispute that, so one alim said this, one alim said this, then what we have to do? Ask the ulama, refer back to your source. What is your source? Come back to Allah and His Messenger. That what is the best thing is. If you know that I am Deobandi, so whatever Deobandi alim said, I must do. I am Bareilly, I must follow Bareilly and no. I must look in the arguments of Alim. If the Alim has argument from the Quran Sunnah, he should be prepared. Even if it's not from my community, he's very Bareilly or Deobandi, whatever, I must obey. By our time, people say, no, I am Deobandi, I must follow Deobandi Alim. I should find a Deobandi Alim who can say, this is not obeying Allah's Messenger, it's obedience of your own culture, your own tradition, and that's not love. You must know the ulama have. Ulama are there only to help me. Ulama are not to be obeyed. Ulama are only to help me. If Alim cannot help you, leave him. Ulama are only to help you to explain what Allah and His Messenger say. If Alim cannot help you, then leave him. Find someone else who can help you. That's the meaning.
How can we differentiate between trustworthy scholars and untrustworthy scholars? Because unfortunately, these days, encounter a lot of people who claim to have authentic religious knowledge, but they don't.
Yeah, you're right. There are so many people going on. But the thing is, it is a human effort. Human effort. You can do effort. And if you do best effort and do mistake, Allah will forgive you. Like for example, when your child becomes ill and you have to find a doctor, severe illness, so you make effort. You know there are so many fake doctors in the world. But you ask people, and also you know that your GP cannot go to a specialist medical. You can see. So similarly, in the religion, whenever you have a question, if it's a small question, you can go to a local alim who is taken care of. Sometimes you can ask what is your evidence. Sometimes you can take a question to be much bigger. Then you ask more specialist or more expert. But look at two things. One is that person must have knowledge, knowing Arabic language properly or has Sunnah properly. And same thing, he must be pious, God-fearing person. He's not a person who made business, religious business. He wants to make money. If two conditions are fulfilled, more likely he's right. But keep asking other people also about him. If you make your best effort and still you do mistake, Allah will forgive you. The problem is most people don't do mistake. What they don't do effort. What they say, if somebody has turban, they ask him. So turban does not make a alim. The thing properly. Turban actually cannot do anything. If you have a headache and put on a turban, he's going to cure you. But I don't know why people think in for an alim you need to have a turban. If somebody has a turban, they go for it. Turban cannot help you. You have to have knowledge. If people have knowledge, that's what you need here. You have to find out the people, the knowledge and the piety. I think so.
Shukran.